Ellen McCauley at Pray It Out. We're talking about being nice to yourself and how it affects our weight. Stop trying to lose weight and start being nice to your body. One day I talked about in this group about putting cream on your body after showering. And I talked about how I would literally take the cream and go slap, 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 slap. All right, done. You're supposed to cream your body after showering. I just did. And then one day I said, you know, when I get my nails done, she takes cream and she massages my hands. And I'm sitting there going, my eyes are rolling in the back of my head. Oh, that feels so good. Oh. So I got some cream after a shower one night and I went to my legs and I'm like putting it in, rubbing, going on the back. I spent like 5 minutes putting cream on my legs. My legs felt good. They were more saturated with cream. I wasn't just... I deserve to put cream on myself after a shower and spend some time. Now, I wasn't standing in front of a mirror going, Ellen, you're so beautiful, here's your face. I mean, I wasn't going to that other extreme, but I was taking some time to self-pamper myself, if you will. One of the troubles about people who want to lose weight is they say they're on a diet. I'm on a diet. It's a diet group. Sometimes people call me up and they say, I can't make it to diet class tonight, Ellen. And I'm thinking, ooh, it's not a diet class. It's a new way of life. It's a new way of looking at life. And one of the things about looking at your life is what you do to cram in a day. You know, I have a busy job. I'm planning a big event. I have a mom who needs my help at times, a family. Even though my children are adults, does that mean they still don't need some stuff? Believe me, they never go away. They need stuff. Also, you know, the house. You know what it's like. So Sunday, I went to Mass, and then I started frenetically doing all this stuff. And finally at 5 o'clock, I said, Bob, do you got a minute? He's like, yeah. I go, Bob, I can't do anymore. I'm just so tired. Would it be all right if I just kind of stop for the day? And he goes, well, yes. Why are you asking me this? I said, because I need papal dispensation. I need someone else to say it's okay to quit. Because I didn't want to be nice enough to say, wow, Ellen, you did a lot. It's 5 o'clock. Why don't you stop? Why don't you stop? Don't we do that to ourselves? Push, push, push. There's a couple hours in the day. Maybe I should be doing this. Maybe I should be doing that. I want to be nice to Ellen. I want to be nice so that I can have time to be nice to other people. This person said, after years and years of being on a diet, I decided to stop trying to lose weight. Now I was more than 220 pounds at that time. And I said, you know what? I'm just going to try to eat healthy. I'm going to be nice to my body. Food used to be a tool that helped me deal with my emotions and my daily habits. When I was stressed, tired, happy, worried, excited, thirsty, I'd have a can of Coke, which is poison, by the way. I'd have some snacks to relax. I'm not afraid of food anymore. I'm not afraid of myself anymore. The relationship I have with food now is sane. I eat to give energy to my body and my mind. I still enjoy good food, but food is not controlling me anymore. And she started by giving up sugar for a month. Now, I have been on a Whole30, no dairy, no gluten, no sugar, for over 3 years. And it's really helped me enormously, and I feel so much better. Now, sugar, I don't mean the natural sugar that God puts in an apple. I don't mean the natural sugar that's in a strawberry. I mean high fructose corn syrup, I mean soda, I mean anything that has sugar in it. Fruits begin to start taste so good. When you have strawberries, blueberries, when you have grapefruit, they just taste so good when you give up that processed sugar. And then she says, processed food is evil. And you know what? I agree. And you think, what is processed food? It's just about everything. It's not chicken or fish. I'm talking about regular fish broiled. It's not vegetables. It's the ready-made tomato sauce. It's the preserving agents. It's the coloring agents. When your body eats a banana, your body is programmed to say, That's a banana. I'm going to put that vitamin here. I'm going to do this with that. I'm going to process that banana. But when you eat processed food, your body says, what is that? I have no idea what to do with that coloring agent, that chemical. I'm going to put it in those fat cells. So you think you're eating a lean cuisine that has 180 calories and you're going to lose weight? Well, your fat cells are going, bring it on, sister. I want that chemical. You can put it right here, right here. So I believe that processed food is evil. Fruits and vegetables are her best friend. She enjoys cooking. She exercises because she wants to, not because she's told to. She tried to find something she liked and she ended up skateboarding. Now, is there skateboarders in the room? Raise your hand. So if those of you who aren't skateboarding right now, I don't suggest you do it at 690, but you might want to check that out. The word diet is my enemy. What I say to myself instead is this food good for me? That is what she says, and I agree. Now, we're talking about being nice to your body by eating things. I put in here 30 ways to be a nicer person, and I want you to pick one and talk about it in your group for next week and actually try it. And the reason I picked these 30 is there are things you can do without becoming stressed yourself. There are things you can do to be nice while at the same time not putting undue pressure. Be punctual. Everyone in this room knows I start at 6:00 and we get out at 7:00. They know it. Look how punctual you all were tonight. It's a beautiful thing. It's a kindness. It's respect. When you are punctual, you're saying to another person, you are valuable. I value your time. I value my time. Be punctual. These are easy. Don't be critical. Oh, the world is so critical. All I hear about is visiting professor from taxes and this one and that one. And I say to Bob, critical, critical, critical. I said, is there anything on the ballot that says none of the above? And didn't somebody write a letter to the editor today and say, can I say none of the above? So I wasn't the only one who thought that. Smile and laugh. How easy is that to do, everybody? I watched the blogs from last week, and when I got to the part where I said, God has bigger fish to fry, and speaking of fried fish, I started laughing. I thought it was funny. Don't talk about yourself as much. Do you know why I never complain? Because as soon as I complain to someone, it's no longer about me, it's about them. Like if I say, oh, my job is really stressful, they'll say, ha, what about my job? Let me tell you about my job. And then they'll go on and on. And then my neighbor's got a job. You should have that job. And I'm thinking, I don't want to complain because it's not about you anymore. So try not to complain. Be interested in others. And don't text on your phone when someone's talking to you. Mm-hmm. Don't watch TV if someone's asking you a question. Don't make jokes about others at others' expense. I hate that. Somebody will say to me, not lately, but they'll say, oh, I got a funny Helen Keller joke. And I say, oh, I don't listen to those. And they're usually stunned. They're like, what? I go, I don't listen to Helen Keller jokes. Mm-hmm. Well, it's funny. I go, no, I don't listen to it. Thank you, though, but no. I don't listen to any jokes that are at anyone else's expense, especially someone as wonderful and as incredible as Helen Keller. Also say please and thank you and be grateful. That doesn't take any stress, any time. Don't gossip. Pay compliments. Someone came in here with a whole new hairdo and I was all over it. Your hair looks fantastic. Also, when you help others, make sure that you're not helping them to stress yourself. If you have the time, if you can help others. That's why I things like the food pantry, you're helping others, and is that a lot of sweat off your brow? You buy some extra boxes. You can be kind and not stress yourself out. Remember people's names. I feel that's so important. I think in small groups, you should make sure that everyone knows everyone else's names. I had 20 new people in session 22, and I know all their names. Your name is your most important asset. Also, just be humble. And I'm telling you, Working outside the home teaches everyone humility. Because if your job place is anything like mine, they're not going, oh, Ellen, you're wonderful, you're awesome, you're great. Now you do something wrong and they'll say, I think you need to change that. But as far as humility goes, I think we need to find our own value. And this has been a lesson for me in knowing that you've done the best you could. That you don't need to have other people tell you you did a good job. You know you did a good job. Also, encourage others. And this is a big one. Learn other cultures. And I bring that up for the food part of it. You don't see a lot of these other cultures struggling with obesity as much as Americans do because they're not eating processed food. They're eating vegetables and protein. So try some Asian food. Try, and I don't mean Italian food. I don't mean, I'm talking the healthy food, okay? Never say I told you so, even if you did, especially to your children who are adults. Just bite your tongue. Also, be fully present to others. And I just say, be sincere. If you're sincere, that's so important. And I'm going to stop right there, Bob.